Somewhere in my 40-somethingth hour of Chivalry 2, my head was struck from my shoulders, and I watched as a superior force overran our defenses and danced on our corpses. But I was not owned. I was laughing, actually. In fact, I had never been mad. Not once. Not even for a second. And I'm not doing a bit. The game has never made me mad. Ooh. I don't think it is a controversial statement to say that playing video games online can make you feel really bad. Even in games that I love, I've hated my opponents and quietly cursed my teammates and felt personally attacked by the developers. Chivalry 2 has all of the ingredients of a bad time online, but somehow it's one of the least stressful multiplayer games I've ever played. Because for every pain point, the devs have a perfectly silly or genius solution. Matchmaking has improved a lot over the years, but somewhere along the way, it started feeling like a big commitment, and I blame those goddamn electronic sports. Releasing an esports viable title opens up marketing and event opportunities, but it also means you gotta batten down the hatches. No more insanely messed up team compositions. No more switching teams just because you're tired of defending. No quitting an hour-long match halfway through when your domino shows up, because you're gonna have to click through like a dozen pop-ups yelling at you for abandoning your team and threatening you with detention. Devs use these rules and restrictions to make sure that people are taking the game seriously and not leaving their teammates in a lurch, which is fair, but it also raises the stakes and makes it more likely that you're gonna get yelled at or want to yell at somebody. Getting in and out of a game of Chivalry 2 will feel pretty familiar to people who were playing a lot of online shooters like 20 years ago. It's old school, but in 2021, this laissez-faire matchmaking attitude feels like a revelation. You join a server where a game is probably in progress. You get in there, you swing your sword around, maybe storm a castle, and then you drop out whenever you're done. No hassle, no shame. Team swapping is another refreshingly old-school thing you can just do in Chivalry 2. And sometimes, if your team is doing too well, you might just get drafted to the other side. Suddenly, all your work towards victory is for nothing. But that's okay. Chivalry focuses on minute-to-minute enjoyment. The purpose of the game isn't really to complete the objectives, it's to have fun. The objectives are only there to move the action along and corral the players into that sweet sword mosh pit. Serious matchmaking is like being in an intramural softball team. If you bail part of the way through a game to go get Taco Bell, you're gonna ruin it for everyone else and get some passive-aggressive emails. By contrast, a Chivalry 2 server is a dog park, from the dog's perspective. You arrive and join a crowd of other beautiful, stupid animals in a chase or wrestle or play fight. Over the course of the day, hundreds of dogs might rotate in and out of that one sustained game, participating in an unbroken, unspoken contract of collaborative enjoyment. I think that's nice. But what if one of those dogs is just too fucking big? Chivalry has a solution for that too. It sucks to load into an online game and find that you are completely, utterly, hopelessly outmatched. I do think there's a lot of value in playing against more skilled players, but it's not always fun. It can be even worse if you're up against a coordinated group of tryhards who are determined to totally shut you down. Chivalry 2 addresses this frustration with one genius mechanic: the riposte. Here's how it works. The enemy swings at you, you block, and immediately respond with an attack of your own. That follow-up attack, or riposte, is faster than a normal attack, and also comes with about half a second of auto guard, which means that you'll deflect all incoming attacks during your attack. Now you're probably saying, gosh, that must be some frame-perfect 5000 MMR high-execution gamer tech. But no. You right-click, then left-click. That's it. You'll probably do it on accident. Mechanically speaking, it's one of the most overpowered tools in the game, but it's balanced by the fact that it can only be used when you're under attack. It's an equalizer. Parries and ripostes mean one player can hold off a swarm of opponents, and it's actually fun rather than demoralizing. If you kill them all, you feel like a god. If you hold them off for a while, you made a brave last stand. And if you get demolished, you can always just tell yourself there was fucking five of them. And speaking of dying, it's generally the one thing you're not supposed to do in a competitive game, so it tends to sting. And depending on the game, it can lead to the dreaded meat grinder phenomenon. When you die, your team has to bravely soldier on at a disadvantage. By the time you respawn and run back, other members of your team have also died and are also running back, so you're still at a disadvantage. You either consciously hang back to regroup or continue diving into the meat grinder, a series of bite-sized snacks for your enemy. Once again, Chivalry's solutions are silly and brilliant. Dying in Chivalry 2 stings less because 99% of the time, it's hilarious. The camera jumps out into third person and you see your opponent whack your head off your shoulders like a t-ball champ and your stupid body goes ragdolling through the air. Every death is a procedurally generated slapstick stunt, and that gives you something to smile about even as you're failing.
I'm a one-armed man! No, I really can't do this.
And when somebody slays you with a perfectly targeted chicken, you can use the commend action to throw some extra points their way. Remember to tip your murderers, folks. When it comes to respawning, Chivalry pulls another clever trick to keep you out of the meat grinder. Rather than popping back in all in your lonesome, your team respawns in waves. That means you'll come back alongside a whole gang of buddies, all screaming and automatically running in the right direction. That's procedurally enforced teamwork. And speaking of teams, lots of people have anxiety about hopping into online games with good reason. People can be fucking mean or just super annoying. Luckily, Chivalry has fixes for this too. First of all, you can totally turn off voice and text communications, and it's fine. A lot of modern games let you turn this off, but it can sometimes feel like you're at a disadvantage. In Chivalry, there's not a lot of valuable tactical information you need to communicate. You just stick them with the pointy end. And who needs to talk when you can yell?
The ships are lost.
Yep, there's a yell button. Chivalry 2 has a bunch of emotes and callouts on its communication wheel, but the only one with its own standalone button is a good old-fashioned holler. Communal yelling is one of the greatest joys of Chivalry. It's funny, and it creates camaraderie even without a voice or text chat. But like most of the other silly stuff in the game, there's some genius to how it works. See, if you yell too much too fast, you'll temporarily be muted to the people around you. But on your screen, you're still hollering to your heart's content. The yell button and its dynamic muting kind of exemplifies Chivalry's thoughtful, fun-first game design philosophy. It lets individual players have fun by being silly and belligerent, but still puts checks in place to make sure that it's not ruining somebody else's fun. With stuff like the yell button, weaponized chickens, human cannonballs, and slapstick environmental traps, Chivalry 2 is communicating that if you're taking this game really, 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 really seriously, then you're the weird one. On one hand, I don't think I'm ever gonna walk away from a match of Chivalry feeling a sense of accomplishment like my hard work and training paid off in the heat of battle. But on the other hand, I don't think I'll ever be mad. That's why I love Chivalry 2. It's a competitive game, but that competition is only for the sake of mutual enjoyment. It's not about the destination. It's about the friends we decapitated along the way.